In the flower art photography tutorial, we use a wide variety of skills and techniques. Many of them might have been new to you, while for others, you might have found new possibilities. By implementing these techniques in our flower portraits, we can get amazing results. The images we create with them have a beautiful, dreamy, and romantic look. Now, you don't want to limit these skills to your flower photography. They actually can be used in a wide range of photography. Use them creatively and experiment with them. Try to implement these skills in your daily photography, and you might discover new possibilities. The most obvious use of these techniques is, of course, in other types of macro or close-up photography, like for these mushrooms, for example. The build-up of these images is quite similar to our flower portraits. Also here, all details matter. Adding depth by using various layers, including foreground elements, a pleasing background, and supporting subjects. And of course, the use of selective focus to pull all attention on the mushroom and to create a dreamy and romantic feel. You can also use the technique on animals, big and small. Use the techniques while shooting insects. And when I started to get serious in photography, I was shooting a lot of frogs. It's a shame that back then I didn't know all these techniques yet. But I'm still shooting frogs, and now I can take advantage of the shooting through technique, the selective focus, and the implementation of a wonderful background. And since, my frog photography has improved a lot. Now my frog portraits have a more mysterious look. The beautiful soft background lifts the images to a higher level. And what to think about portrait photography? That's also a good opportunity to implement the skills learned in this tutorial. Well, actually, I don't really shoot many portraits, but I can show you these images. Some portraits of wild chimpanzees using the shooting through technique. I really love the soft, dreamy, and mystical feel in these images. Now, why not try to use these techniques in other fields of photography? Just be creative and experiment. I'm sure that the dreamy look works wonderful in wedding photography. And here I used some of the techniques in forest photography. As you can see in all these examples, you can use the techniques of this tutorial on a wide range of photography fields. The only limiting factor is your imagination. Explore different options and experiment.